Is the world ready for its first Asian or African pope? Will the next pope be younger? Monica Magpantay gives us a look at the apparent frontrunners in the papal succession, including our very own Manila Archbishop Luis Antonio Cardinal Tagle.
Sabato scorso, al termine degli esercizi spirituali, amore e fede,
since Pope Benedict XVI announced his resignation, many have been asking, will the Catholic Church finally elect its first non-European leader? While there are no official candidates, several names of papabili or potential popes are being floated in the media. Among them is Manila's own Archbishop, the 55-year-old Luis Antonio Cardinal Tagle. Reuters reports Tagle has a charisma often compared to that of the late Pope John Paul II. Tagle also became close to Benedict as they worked together at the International Theological Commission. But some say Tagle's age and the fact that he became a cardinal just last year could weaken his chances. The Reuters Vatican correspondent offers a different view.
I would think that the last thing they want to do is elect another old pope who will be put into the same situation in a matter of 5 or maybe even 10 years. So it seems that the odds of having a younger pope are much greater this time.
While the CBCP's Father Francis Lucas acknowledges it's a dream to have a Filipino pope, he says it's ultimately up to the conclave.
Let us not talk of pushing our own candidates. Kasi maling-mali eh. Maling-mali, that's totally wrong. Leave it to the Holy Spirit to really inspire them on a pope who will really serve as a good pastor, firm in his faith, and with all humility and faith, push for what is good for the whole society. Kasi as a shepherd, hindi lang niya inaalagaan yung mga Katoliko dyan eh. He's a shepherd of all the people in the world.
In Africa, Ghana's Peter Turkson is often tipped as the front runner. Head of the Vatican's Justice and Peace Department, Turkson is the spokesperson for the church's social conscience. Aside from him, there's also Nigeria's Francis Arinze, who was a close advisor to Pope John Paul II. Another favorite is New York Archbishop Timothy Dolan, who became the voice of U.S. Catholicism. But a Time magazine article says there is a, quote, traditional bias against giving the most powerful job in the church to a citizen of the world's most powerful country. Also reported to be in the running is Canadian Cardinal Mark Woolley, prefect of the Congregation for Bishops, the church's human resources department. Woolley once said becoming a pope would be a nightmare. If it's Latin America's turn, the leading choice seems to be Brazil's Odilo Pedro Scherer, Archbishop of Sao Paulo. Brazil has the largest Catholic population worldwide with nearly 127 million. There's also Argentina's Leonardo Sandri, who was born in Buenos Aires to Italian parents. Sandri heads the Vatican Department for Eastern Churches. But if the papacy remains with Europe, observers say Milan Archbishop Angelo Scola is the strongest contender. Scola has been an outspoken opponent of civil unions in Italy and also leads a foundation to promote Muslim-Christian understanding. Italian Cardinal Gianfranco Ravasi's name also cropped up. As the Vatican's culture minister, Ravasi represents the church to the worlds of art, science, and culture. From Austria, Christoph Schönborn is seen as papal material as well. The Vienna Archbishop is Benedict's former student and close ally. While these names have come out in reports, it's definitely possible that none of them will become the next pope. Back in 1978, then-Cardinal Karol Wojtyla was not considered the front-runner, but he went on to lead the Catholic Church as John Paul II for 27 years. Monica Magpantay, ABS-CBN News.